himself some more.
Another lovely square cut. And that's gone through before.
I think we met at a cricket party in Calcutta. He had come to play, and of course we were all cricket mad and cricketer mad also. It was the man that I loved, and it seemed to worry everybody else that he was a Nawab. Like, it will be height of Ayashi, and you know, he was feudal and he didn't have a 9-to-5 job.
Senior Nawab, whatever little I saw, he was a man who could create innings like Gavaskar. While Nawab was exactly opposite, he will go for the ball. No comparison between two styles. He was the most intelligent captain I have seen in my life.
Tiger was the first captain, to my mind, who told us in no uncertain terms, look, fellas, you're not playing for Bombay or Madras or Punjab or Delhi or any other state. You're playing for India. Think India. My only complaint is that he was too lazy, he was too laid back. I can't imagine a captain of a side not having a kit bag of his own. See, he would use somebody else's pads, somebody else's gloves. The bat is the most important element. And then he will say, all right, like that, all right, this is all right for me. And he'll just pick it up and go in.
The earliest memories I have, I think, of being really tiny, people saying, hello, beta, what does your father do? And I'd say, he's the captain of India, and be very proud.
I did play some cricket at university. I played one match, and he told me after that, he said, I forbid you from playing cricket ever again.
So I think I would have loved to have been there, you know, during the 70s. Basically, with both my parents, because it was a different time. And you see the stories, you see the pictures, you see the kind of life they had, the glamour combined with the simple nuances. But that era was something else.
How glad the many millions of Timothys and Williams would be to capture me.
From being a prince in Bhopal and Prodi to Oxford and Winchester and India that it was in those days. And of course, playing international cricket with one eye. He was like Al Pacino to me. Slightly taller version. And definitely better at cricket.
And that's gone through for four, and that's his 100. Recording 6 test 100.
He had no one eye. He had no one shoulder, he had no one thigh. because he was threw out of the windscreen of the car with all those such handicaps. He was still the best fielder of the era. Company knock was at Melbourne. Don Bradman himself came in lunchtime and he said, young man, I wish I had some shots like you. What a tribute.
When you get older, it's the mad things that you've done is what you remember, no?
On another occasion, he took some cricketers deep into the woods. Suddenly there was a group of dacoits raiding the cricketer. Unhone ek ko pakda, Vijay Manjrekar. Latka diya usko, ki ye get us this kind of ransom, otherwise he's going.
And Manjrekar didn't know, honestly, till the time he died, he didn't know that this was all stage managed.
And I remember him coming and telling me, I've written this for you. Dile nada, tujhe hua kya hai? Aakhir is dard ki dawa kya hai? Next day, I said, Firoz, you know, Tiger's done such a wonderful thing for me. Firoz said, you idiot woman. That's Ghalib, for God's sake.
A loss for Indian cricket today. Former Indian cricket captain Mansoor Ali Khan Pataudi is no more.
Bada dukhad din hai, Tiger hamesha ke liye chhodkar chala gaya.
The man oozed style on the field where he was a terrific cricketer. Off the field, the classic gentleman.
I think the most important thing Abba has demonstrated by example, what it is to be honorable and correct and dignified and strong and silent.
It was a film that we made on Tiger's 70th birthday. This was last year on the 5th of January. And as you can see, it has been slightly modified and edited. So that's why it is really a very personal film, looking at him from our point of view, the family's point of view, not really celebrating him as a cricketer, but what he meant for us. And I'm especially happy that the venue is Calcutta, where I first met my husband, and I got married from the city also. And for number of reasons, both professional and personal, this city had meant a lot for both of us. Also, I have wonderful memories from Sharjah days. And I remember Tiger and him writing columns for Gulf News. And Tiger was very, very restrained, very economical with words to the point of being very laconic. And Imran was, of course, very flamboyant and forthcoming and wonderful advice for his teammates, but both very constructive and very enlightening. But I think I better stop right there, because I was horrified when I read Tiger Patodi Memorial Lecture Introduction by Sharmila Tagore, because ever since I had a chat with Peter May, I don't know if any of you know it, but I've said it many times, and was extolling the virtue of the leg cut when I received a massive kick under the table, and I was forbidden to talk about cricket ever again. I think it was in my Nikanama also that you're not to talk about cricket. So now that I'm educated and grown up and an adult, I know it's a late cut, but ban is a ban, so I better honor it. So I will just allow me to, on my family's behalf and Tiger's and my behalf, to thank all of you for instituting this award, and I wish the initiative all the success it deserves.
I grew up admiring two cricketers. One was my first cousin, Javed Barkhi. And Javed Barkhi and Mansoor Ali Khan played together at Oxford. So they were in the same team along with another Indian, Abbas Ali Beg. So the three of them were at Oxford about a decade before me. So as a boy growing up, Javed Barkhi was, because he was my first cousin, my family, we always wanted to emulate him. So here was someone who was good at studies and also good at sports. So this, thank God I followed a role model. Otherwise I would not have studied. And the biggest blunder I would have made if I had not studied. The other, of course, big reason I studied was my mother. So when I was 18 and on the verge of playing for Pakistan, she insisted that I would only play if I completed my education afterwards. So of course we had these role models. And when I, and from Javed Barkhi, we always used to ask about Mansoor Ali Khan. And now this is what he used to say. Now remember, I'm a child growing up, my hero telling me, he said that if Mansoor Ali Khan had not lost his eye, he felt that he would have broken all records. That such was his talent in university when they used to be playing together. He said the quality of strokes he could play, he said mere mortals could not play those strokes. And to actually have gone on with one eye and have the sort of record which Mansoor Ali Khan had, the mind boggles what he could have done with both eyes. So we grew up, me looking up to my cousin Javed Barkhi, who became the youngest test captain of Pakistan, sadly only for one series. He had similar sort of experience which the current Indian team is going through. And he was dropped. But Tiger did go on to captain India for a long time. And when I first saw him, it was in a benefit match in Hyderabad. I don't know what benefit, it was my first time in India, and it was my first experience meeting Tiger. And I had always looked up to him, this amazing, glamorous cricketer who was also educated. Remember, the two, just for the audience, it is the most difficult thing to do, to play international sport as well as complete your university education. It is the most difficult thing to do. Those who have done it would understand how difficult it is. Because by the time you are 14 to 15, if you have to play international sport, you have such a focus, the obsession is such that everything else falls away. If you do not have the focus, you cannot make it. So then to force yourself to also study, it takes incredible willpower. But once you do it, you have a huge advantage over other sportsmen who haven't had university education. So did Tiger. He also went to quality school, good sporting facilities, and good education. Successful people, the advantage of the reason why people are successful is because, not because how they handle success, how they handle failure. In failure, you should have the ability to be able to analyze your mistakes better than others. You should be your best critic. That power of analysis is sharpened by quality education. I met Tiger Pataudi in 1977. We were in awe of him. And as Bishan Singh Bedi said, I have never seen a more casual man than him. You know, I mean, a cricket bat. Now look, you have to have a bat. The more you play, the more you realize that there are certain bats that fit you, the grip and so on. To just pick up a bat and just go into, it's unheard of in the cricketing world. But what Pataudi had, what the current, in the cricketing world I'm talking about, what you miss now, is that cricket was not his bread and butter. It's very important to understand this. Because if it becomes your profession, you will never take the risks to achieve great heights. You will always play it safe. For me, people who achieve great things in this world, whether it's in sport or anywhere, have that ability to take risks. You aim high, you take risks, and you develop this fearlessness. that you think that whatever happens, you will be able to cope with it. What is called, which makes you invincible, is self-belief. You believe in yourself. You think whatever happens, you can overcome it. And so you take these risks, you take the fall, but you think you can pick yourself up and again take on anything. In my experience in county cricket in England, I found that this is what the bread and butter county cricketer, whose profession was county cricket, they refused to take risks because they were scared that it was a job. Now, this is the big difference, which I always thought Tiger treated cricket as something, you know, which was to be enjoyed. It was a challenge. It was to achieve heights which others hadn't achieved. But it wasn't his bread and butter. And that's why he was so flamboyant. That's why he had this charisma. So he could maximize this talent. Tiger could have probably got more runs, but he would have lost that flamboyance. And so this is what made him such an attractive role model for people like us. I again repeat, my mind boggles what he would have been if he could see from both eyes. Because anyone who has batted, and especially against fast bowling, even spinners, but fast bowling, there's no way you can have that same. With one eye, you just cannot play fast bowling the way he did. I remember Ian Chappell met me, first time when I met Ian Chappell, and I asked him, because we were so curious about this enigma. So I asked him about Tiger, and he told me about these runs he had got in Melbourne against Australia, and Garth McKenzie was, at that time, one of the fastest bowlers. And he just told me how he had just destroyed him with one eye. So a cricketer would really understand what a monumental task he had, not only to make the name he did with one eye. And I remember asking him how it happened, and it's just one of the freaks which happens in one's lives that stopped him from probably achieving double what he achieved.
Indian cricket captain Mansoor Ali Khan Pataudi is no more.
But Tiger,
the man oozed style on the field where he was a terrific cricketer, off the field, the classic gentleman.
I think the most important thing Abba has demonstrated by example what it is to be honourable and correct and dignified and strong and silent